welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo and his friends are happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy.
We hope you're ready for another fun day in Elmo's world. I know I certainly am.
Same for all of us. So Elmo, what are we thinking about today?
Today, Noah, Elmo is thinking about horses.
Ah, horses. What a great thing to think about. Horses are some of the greatest animals there are in the world.
Agreed. Horses come in all sizes. Tall horses, little horses. And they're even good for riding on. And they're also some animals that need feeding, brushing, and other stuff. Horses are just so much fun. And there's even some horses on a merry-go-round. Fun ride. Hey, what do you like about horses? Ooh, what a great thing to like about horses. I wonder what other stuff a horse can do.
Elmo's curious about that too.
What a great idea. We'll play Spots Clues to figure it out. We are gonna play Spots Clues, cause it's a really great game, yeah. So remember, Spots Paw Prints will be on the clues. Spots Clues. You know what we need for Spots Clues. Our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what else horses can do. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spots Clues, we've got to find three
paw prints. Three paw prints, right. And we've got to find our first clue.
A clue?
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spots Clues. Spots Clues.
We've got to find another paw print. That's the second.
Spots Clues.
You know what to do. Sit down in our thinking chair and think. Think. Think.
Take a step at a time. We can do anything.
What?
That we want to do. Are you ready? It's time to play Spots Clues to figure out what else horses can do. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh, what's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you pretend to ride a horse?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle, okay, Dorothy? Good. Oh. Hey, Shane. Go up, please. Oh, Shane is horsing around. Come on, Shane, giddy up. Oh, thanks, Shane.
Oh, look. It's Mr. Noodle's brother, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, hi, Mr. Noodle. Oh, wow, that's a pretty flower, Mr. Noodle. Very pretty. Uh-oh. Oh. Are you okay, Mr. Noodle? Oh, you okay? Good. Oh. Mr. Noodle, Dorothy has a question. How do you pretend to ride a horse, Mr. Noodle?
Yeah, how do you pretend to ride a horse?
Okay. Here he goes. What's he doing?
Wait, Mr. Noodle.
What are you doing?
Looks like he's putting on a seatbelt.
Mr. Noodle, that's a car.
Not a car, Mr. Noodle.
No,
that's not riding a horse.
Well, that's very good pretending, Mr. Noodle, but you're not pretending to ride a horse. A horse, Mr. Noodle.
Think horse. You can do it. Try again. What's he doing?
What's that?
He's getting into something.
What is Mr. Noodle
Wait, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle, that's not a horse.
I think it's a boat. He's rowing a boat.
Mr. Noodle's pretending to row a boat.
Row, row, row your boat.
Wait, Mr. Noodle.
You remember what a horse is?
How do you ride a horse?
There's a horse. It's cute. Look, a whole bunch of horses.
Those are horses, Mr. Noodle.
Now you got it?
Try again. You can do it.
Here he goes. That's it.
Up on the horse. I think he's got it.
Yay!
Mr. Noodle's riding.
Yee-haw! Good pretending, Mr. Noodle.
He's a cowboy.
Owdy, Peltner.
Whoa, he's going now.
You can stop now, Mr. Noodle. Slow down.
Whoa, boy. Mr. Noodle.
Poor Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle's imagination is running away with him.
Think we should help him?
He'll be fine. He'll stop eventually. Right now we've got something on our own to attend to. And that's clue finding. Come on, let's go. Sailor Jupiter.
Hey guys, heard you were learning about horses today.
Sure are. And we're just about to go look for clues. Care to join us?
Of course, and it's a good thing I brought my notebook with me.
Good, the more the merrier. Okay, now let's go look for clues.
Ooh, that actually reminds me. Look what I found.
Oh, it's a clue. Sailor Jupiter found a clue. And it's a horse.
Oh boy, we have our first clue. Hey Jupiter, why don't you draw this clue?
Oh, sure thing, guys. So, a horse. Let's draw an oval for the horse's body, a puffy shape like this for the tail. Lines for the horse's legs, two circles for the hooves. The neck here, the horse's head, eyes, and a mouth. There, a horse.
So what else do you think horses can do with a horse? Oh, good idea. But let's find two more clues to figure this out.
Ooh, well, until then, we can figure out the answer to Elmo's question. How many teeth can we see in this horse's mouth? Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us.
Oh, that was it. Thank you.
That really is such a nice smile for that horse. And it sure has perfect teeth as well.
I agree. Good for that horse.
Yeah. Ooh, now Elmo wants to know, where do horses live?
Now that's a good question. Horses live in different places. But what kind of places are those? How are we gonna figure this out?
You'll be able to figure that out with the help of the drawer game.
Where's drawer?
Allow Elmo.
Oh, drawer! Drawer thinks he's a horse! Yeah! Hey, yo, drawer! Away!
Bark, bark, bark.
Every time.
Do horses live in a tree? In a barn? Or on the moon?
In a barn.
Do horses live in a shoe? In an apartment? Or in a field?
In a field.
Do horses live in a cave? On a cloud? Or in the ocean?
Seahorses live in the ocean, but not horses. Horses don't live in any of those places.
Unless it's Snuffy pretending to be a horse. He lives in a cave.
Clippity-clop, 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 clippity-clop.
Well, I guess that answers our question to where horses live.
Sure does. Thanks for that spot.
Anytime. Until next time.
Even as a horse, we'll never get the drawer to cooperate.
Don't worry, we'll find a way to get the drawer to cooperate with Elmo someday. But as usual, this isn't the time for it. Right now, we still need to find more clues to figure out what else horses can do. Come on!
A clue!
You see a clue? Is it behind us, or in front of us?
Behind you!
Oh, there it is. Our second clue is numbers. Numbers are our second clue.
All right, I'll go first. Let's draw a 5, then a 3, and then a 7. There, numbers.
Okay, my turn. So we draw a 5, then a 3, and then a 7. There, numbers.
Okay, now me. So we have a 5, then a 3, and then a 7. There, numbers. So, our first clue is a horse.
So what else do you think horses can do with a horse and numbers?
But let's find our last clue to figure it out.
Elmo has a mobile
computer! Everybody's a horse today! Computer, come back!
Elmo has mail!
Oh look, it's an email from Larry and Poppy. Hi guys, Poppy and I sent this email to tell you our favorite things about horses. My favorite thing about horses is the Wild Wild West, and other places. Like medieval times, knights always ride on horses.
And what I like about horses, is riding on them. Because riding on horses is so much fun. That's what I like about horses. Those are what we like about horses. Bye guys.
Bye.
Thanks computer.
Those are nice things to like about horses.
Sure are. Ooh, now Elmo wants to learn more about horses, don't you? How can we find out more?
Oh, the TV. That's how we'll learn more. By watching the channel.
Yeah. We can watch the Horse Channel.
Welcome to the Horse Channel. All those who love horses say nay. Nay! And now it's time for a ponytail. The horse who loved his girl.
Once upon a time, there was a horse who loved his girl.
And I love my horse.
The horse loved his girl when she fed him scrumptious, delicious hay and grain. He loved her when she gave him fresh, clean water to drink. He loved her when she gave him a bath.
Wait a minute! Horses don't take baths in bathtubs! Horses take baths outside!
He loved her when she brushed him. And he loved her when they went riding together. Now that's horsepower!
Wait a minute! Horses don't ride in cars! People ride horses. It's great exercise for both of us.
The horse loved his girl when they went slow, and he loved her when they went fast. He loved her no matter what.
I love my girl.
And the rest is horsetory. The end.
Giddy up!
Coming up next on the Horse Channel, Desperate Horse Wives.
Thanks, TV.
Come on. Let's go find Spot.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Hey, Spot just sky dude. Come on, Let's go to Spot Skidoo. We can too.
Wow. What a nice farm drawing.
Hey, more horses.
Hi. I need to run to the market. Could you feed my horses while I'm gone?
Oh, sure. Will you help feed the horses? Great. What should we feed them?
Feed them some raisins. They love raisins. I'll be back later.
Okay, so we need to make sure that the horses are nice and fed.
But how should we know how many raisins we should feed them?
Maybe with this chart. Look, this chart shows how many raisins each horse should get.
Oh, good thinking. You'll help us with this chart, right? Great.
Okay, let's start with the brown horse. Pay close attention to the number of squares there are for the brown horse. How many raisins should we feed the brown horse?
5.
5, right. This says that the brown horse gets 5 raisins. Okay, 5 raisins, coming up. Good job, the brown horse is fed. Okay, who's next?
It looks like the black horse is next. How many raisins should the black horse get?
3.
3, right. Guess the black horse isn't really that hungry. 3 should be enough for him.
Ooh, Elmo wants to feed the black horse. Hungry horses, aren't they?
Very hungry. Okay, so the brown and black horses are fed, just one more to go. Let's see how many raisins the gray horse needs.
Okay, 5 raisins for the brown horse, 3 raisins for the black horse. So how many raisins does the gray horse need?
None.
None? Oh, look at that. There aren't any squares on the gray horse.
None? Really? I guess the gray horse doesn't eat raisins.
Hi, I'm back. Thanks for looking after my horses.
You're welcome. We use this chart to figure out how many raisins the horses should get. The brown horse gets 5 raisins, and the black horse gets 3 raisins. But the gray horse doesn't need any?
Nope, the gray horse likes sunflower seeds.
Ah, that makes more sense. Well, looks like all the horses are well fed.
Thanks for your help.
You're welcome. Glad we could help. Okay, everyone, back to Elmo's world. We still need to find our last clue.
Right, let's go.
A clue, a clue!
You say something?
A clue!
Oh, a clue. Our last clue, and it's a flag. A checkered flag, that is. We have our last clue. I'll draw the clue first. Let's draw a line with a rectangle right here for the flag, and some crisscrossing lines on the inside, and we color in some of the squares for the black squares. There, a checkered flag.
Okay, my turn. So we draw a line with a rectangle here. Some crisscrossing lines on the inside, and we color in some of the squares, for the black squares. There, a checkered flag. Okay, Elmo's turn. So Elmo will draw a line with a rectangle here. Some crisscrossing lines on the inside, and we color in some of the squares, for the black squares. There, a checkered flag.
Hey, we have all 3 clues to figure out what else horses can do. We're ready to sit in our
Thinking chair.
Let's go.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay, so we need to figure out what else horses can do.
And our clues are a horse,
numbers,
and a checkered flag.
So what else do you think a horse can do, with a horse, numbers, and a checkered flag?
Well, what if there are some horses that would have different numbers on them? And maybe the checkered flag is for something the horses need.
Like, when you wave the flag, the horses start running. But what would that be?
Horse racing.
Horse racing? Oh yeah, horse racing. Because a horse race has some horses, with numbers for the racing numbers, and the checkered flag is for telling when to start the race. What a great thing for horses. We just figured out Spot's clues. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because they're really smart.
That's right. I totally forgot about that. Horses can also race too. Horse racing is a sport.
That's right. Horses can also race too.
Oh boy, that's a good choice there, Spot. Horse racing. How about that?
Bark, bark, bark.
Agreed. So, now that we know what else horses can do, what else should we do now?
Well, Elmo wants to learn more about horses. How can we find out more?
Who could that be?
Want to talk to a horse?
Oh, yeah, we could talk to a horse, of course. Oh, come on in, horses.
Well, thank you.
Welcome.
Well, nice neighborhood.
Well, thank you. Tell Elmo about yourself, horsey.
Well, I'm a stable sort of a guy.
Oh, wow. Look at that, more horses.
Yep. This is my herd.
Oh, have you heard? We're a herd.
Horses like to stick together. We've got a new baby, too, Wilbur.
Oh, look at him.
Say hi, Wilbur.
Oh, boy. Hello, baby horsey Wilbur.
A baby horsey is called a foal.
Really?
No foaling.
Oh, look. Greener pastures. Let's go, y'all.
All right.
I'll catch up with you later.
See you soon. Wow, horsey. Pretty hair.
That's my mane. Horses have manes and tails. Our tails are great for swatting flies. Uh-huh. Oh, there's one now.
Uh-oh. Oh, how can horses tell?
Oh, horses can feel it whenever and wherever a fly lands on us. It's very annoying. Shoo, fly.
Well, does horsey have a hobby?
Well, I'm no hobby horse, if that's what you mean, but I do have a job. Lots of horses have jobs.
Oh, yeah? Well, what kind of jobs?
Well, some horses are cow horses. They round up cattle.
Dorothy is imagining Elmo as a cow horse. Move along, cows. Move along.
Move.
Move along.
Oh, yes, of course, move along. Let's
move along.
Nice young man.
Some horses work as police horses.
No standing, cow. Move along.
Thank you, young man. I thought I'd never get across.
Move along.
And some horses work in the opera.
La donna mobile. Qual prima avete? Elmo horse is a little horse.
Boy, horses are very hard workers.
Very hard workers. Man, what a great horsey day. Thanks for learning about horses with us.
We got a
song! Oh, yeah!
Horses can keep us away!
Horses just love the horse song. Do you mind if we sing along?
Sing with Elmo and friends.
Horses!
That's Elmo's world!
This is Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Elmo's ready for another fun day in Elmo's world once again. And guess what? Today, Elmo is thinking about noses. You know, the thing that's part of your face to help you smell things. Come on, let's go tell the others.
Oh look! They're here.
Oh good. We can't wait for another fun day with you. So Elmo, what's today's thing we're thinking about?
Elmo was just telling our friends that Elmo is thinking about noses.
Ah, noses. That's a good thing to think about. The nose is the most important part of your body.
Such an important part. All noses come in all sizes for people and or animals. Like, look at Spot's and Blue's noses. Spot's nose is this little small dot, and Blue's nose is a little big.
And take a look at Elmo's nose. It's that big orange circle that's his nose.
Yeah, everyone has a nose. Because without a nose, you wouldn't be able to smell anything. Elephants wouldn't be able to take their baths without their trunks as noses. And you probably wouldn't be able to play jokes. Like, got your nose. Hey, what wouldn't you be able to do without your nose?
Ooh, that's definitely something you wouldn't be able to do without a nose. Thank goodness for noses.
You know, I wonder if there's anyone with a special kind of nose.
There is actually. But you'll need to play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
Great idea. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure it out. We love Spot's Clues. We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game. Yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. You know what we need for Spot's Clues. Our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out who has a very special nose. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we've got to find three
paw prints. Three paw prints, right. And we've got to find our first clue.
A clue.
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
We've got to find another paw print. That's the second clue. We put it in our notebook. Because these clues. Spot's Clues.
We've got to find the last paw print. That's the third clue. We put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
You know what to do. Sit down in our thinking chair and think. Think. Think.
Take a step at a time. We can do
anything.
That we want to do. Are you ready? It's time to play Spot's Clues to figure out who has a very special nose. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh, what's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you smell a flower?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle. He has a nose.
Oh, shade!
The Zonkite shade!
Hi, Mr. Noodle! Hi! Oh, there's a fly on Mr. Noodle's nose! Whoa! Oh, shoo, fly, shoo! Oh, thank you, fly!
Ready, Mr. Noodle? Okay, Mr. Noodle, here goes. How do you smell a flower, Mr. Noodle?
Nice flowers, Mr. Noodle.
So how do you smell a flower?
What's he doing?
Mr. Noodle, Mr. Noodle, you're selling a flower. Dorothy asked,
How do you smell a flower?
It's how you smell a flower, not sell a flower. You know.
Yeah, smell.
Now, how do you smell a flower?
Not like that.
That's your ear.
No, not there.
That's your elbow.
No.
Come here, Mr. Noodle. It's on your face.
That's it, your face.
And it rhymes with rose.
Rose. Don't give up.
Here's another clue, Mr. Noodle. Where the fly was.
That fly, yeah.
Yes,
your nose.
Your nose, Mr. Noodle.
You gotta use your nose, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, yay. He's smelling a flower with his nose.
I bet it smells nice.
It squirted him.
It's one of those trick flowers.
No, it's a water lily.
Mr. Noodle.
Thank you, Mr. Noodle. Boy, that Mr. Noodle is such a good sport.
He sure is. A funny good sport, too. Good for him. Well, now that we know how to smell a flower, it's time to go look for clues. Come on!
A clue! A clue!
You have a runny nose. Want us to get you a tissue or something?
No, a clue!
Oh, a clue. You see our first clue. And it's a boy. This boy is our first clue to who has a very special nose. You know what we need, our handy dandy.
Notebook, right. I'll go first. Let's draw a circle for the head. A line like this for the shirt. Some lines down here for the pants. A funny line like this for the hair. Eyes, a curve for the smile. Hands, and the feet. There, a boy.
Okay, my turn. So we have a circle for the head. A line like this for the shirt. A line down here for the pants. The hair on the top, two eyes, a curve for the smile, hands, and the feet. There, a boy. So who do you think has a very special nose, with a boy? Yeah, maybe. But let's find two more clues, just to be sure.
In the meantime, Elmo, you wouldn't happen to have a question about noses, would you?
Yes, actually. Elmo wants to know, how many noses are in this year's Tournament of Noses Parade? Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us.
Oh, here it comes!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Oh, and last but not least, our nose of the year, the Nose Queen!
13!
Who said 13's an unlucky number, huh? Boy, the nose was running! Get it? Running!
Good one, Elmo. And great counting, everybody.
Ooh, hey, watch Elmo. Elmo's gonna try to balance this ball on his nose. Ah, the ball fell off.
That's okay, Elmo. You just need to keep on practicing.
Hey, now I have a question. What else has noses?
Oh, good question there, Alex. How can we figure that out?
The same way we always do, with a drawer game.
Ah, yes. Drawer games always help find answers. Careful this time, Elmo.
The first.
Bark, bark, bark.
At least he was still practicing to balance the ball on his nose.
Does a cupcake have a nose?
No.
But you can get cupcake on your nose when you eat it. Does a jet plane have a nose?
Yeah,
but not a nose like that. They call the front part the nose.
Does a trash heap have a nose?
No.
Oh, it has no nose, but it smells terrible.
So does that joke, Oscar.
So, did that answer your question, Alex?
Sure did. Drawer games always seem to help answer your question. Thanks for that, Spot.
Always. Until next time.
That was a pretty good trick there, Elmo. Good to see you're practicing that.
Thanks. Hopefully Elmo will keep it balancing without anything happening.
I'm sure you will. But for now, we should probably keep on looking for clues. Come on!
A clue!
Oh, Elmo's getting some practice on the balancing thing.
No, a clue right there!
Oh, our second clue. There it is. So, our second clue is wood. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Elmo. Elmo will draw this clue. Elmo, draw a rectangle with a line on the back, a taller rectangle behind it, another small one, and a tall one behind it. Some lines on the front. There, wood.
Okay, so our first clue is a boy.
And the second clue is wood.
So who do you think has a very special nose, with a boy, and wood?
Good thinking. But maybe we should find our last clue, just to be sure.
Elmo.
Huh? Oh, Cupcake.
Hey Elmo, I heard you were trying to balance a ball on your nose. Can I see?
Oh, sure thing.
Elmo has mail.
Oh look, it's an email from Two-Headed Monster.
Gesundheit. Elbows.
Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Two-headed monster definitely got the right idea. When you sneeze, you gotta blow into a tissue, or sneeze into your elbow. Because you can get a runny nose a lot when you sneeze.
Wow. I sure hope they feel better soon.
So does Elmo. But now Elmo wants to learn more about noses. Don't you? How can we find out more?
Hey, TV. Right on time. We can watch a channel to learn more about noses.
Yeah, we can watch the Nose Channel. Turn yourself on TV.
From Smell-O-Vision Central, it's the Nose Channel. All noses, all the time. And here is Lola Schnozola with a profile of a prominent proboscis.
Meet the greatest nose in the world, an elephant's trunk. It has 40,000 muscles. Strong! Put Lola down, Tantor. The trunk! It smells! It breathes! Just like your nose! But can your nose feed you lunch? Can your nose pour you a drink of water? Or give you a shower? We're talking nose here! And in trumpets! Play that on your schnozola! A trunk can help dig a hole! Pick up a dime! Pick up a baby elephant! Or a tree! It can help you follow your mummy! And a trunk can hug! The trunk. The super nose that can do just about anything. Put me down, you big pachyderm. Let me off this proboscis.
Stay tuned for Most Happy Smeller and AB's Irish Nose.
Thanks, TV.
Come on. Let's go find Spot.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
There goes Spot. Let's go. Spot, Skidoo. We can too.
Hey, it's Chibi Chibi's world.
Oh boy, I love this place. As far as I know, Chibi Chibi always has some of her friends come here all the time.
You guys, what a surprise.
Hey little sis, looks like we walked in on story time.
And you're right on time too. We're just about to start the story actually. You're welcome to join in on this story.
Oh boy. Do you wanna hear the story too? Great. So, what's today's story?
This story is called, The Nose Book. So, let's begin. I see a nose on every face. I see noses every place. A nose between each part of eyes. Noses, noses, every size. They grow on every kind of head. They come in blue, and pink, and red. Some are very, very long. Some are very, very strong. Everywhere a fellow goes, he sees some new kind of nose. A nose is useful after all. Some play horns, and some play ball.
Oh look, that's the same trick Elmo was practicing on that ball.
Oh, that's where you saw the trick? Interesting. Go ahead, Rosalina.
A nose is good for making holes in trees and roofs and barbed poles. But sometimes noses aren't much fun. They sniffle. They get burned by sun. But just suppose you had no nose. Then you could never smell a rose, or pie, or chicken a-locking. You'd never smell a single thing.
So true. You'd never be able to smell anything without the nose.
And one thing more, suppose, no nose, where would all our glasses sit? They'd all fall off. Just think of it. The end.
Wow, that was a great story. And it really helped us learn a lot about noses. Thanks for the story, Rosalina.
Of course. Glad you were all here to hear the story.
Yeah, it sure was nice to have some company here. Oh, and hey, if you're looking for any clues, I think I saw one somewhere here.
Ooh, I'll go find it. Thanks, sis.
A clue, a clue!
You see our last clue? Here in Chibi Chibi's world? Where?
Right there!
Oh, there it is. Our last clue is a nose. We have our last clue. And we need to put this in our...
notebook!
Notebook, right. For a nose, let's draw a long curved line, like this. There, a nose. Hey, we have all three clues to figure out who has a very special nose. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair. Come on. Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay, so who do you think has a very special nose, with a boy?
Wood. And a nose.
So who do you think it could be?
Well, what if this boy had a nose that was made out of wood? And maybe the boy would be made out of wood as well. Yeah, a whole boy that was entirely made out of wood.
Yeah, that could be it. So, if this boy was made out of wood and had a wooden nose too, who would that be?
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio? Yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's who has a very special nose. It's Pinocchio. You know the story? It's about a little boy that was made out of wood, and his nose always grows when he says things that aren't true. It's Pinocchio who has a very special nose. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because they're really smart.
So, it's Pinocchio who has a very special nose.
That's right. It's Pinocchio who has a very special nose.
Of course, and we all know why. That nose is special, because whenever he says something that's not true, his nose starts to grow, every time he makes something up.
That's right. How about that? Well, now that we're done with another Spot's Clues game, Elmo, why don't you try balancing that ball on your nose again? I know you will get it balanced in no time.
Okay, come on.
I'm gonna try again.
Look, Dorothy! Look, look, Elmo did it! Elmo wants to learn more about noses!
Hey, oh. You, with the ball on your nose.
Not anymore.
Why don't you ask a nose? A proboscis, a schnozola, a smeller, a beezer, a nozzle, a sneezer, a snoot.
Look, 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 a nose!
This nose knows what a nose knows.
Well, what does a nose know, Mr. Nose?
Well, I know where I live. And I love where I live. What a neighborhood in between two eyes.
Two eyes?
Just above a mouth.
A mouth?
Right in the middle of a face.
A face?
Do you ever get the feeling that you're glad you got a nose? Right in the middle of your face. Don't it make you happy that you got your one of those? Right in the middle of your face. Eyes are kinda nice when there's stuff to be seen. But aren't you really thrilled that there's something between them? A proboscis.
A nose.
Everybody's trying to get into the act. Hit it. Did you ever get the feeling that you're glad you got a nose? In between your eyes, up above your mouth, right in the middle. Hey, diddle, diddle, right in the middle of your face. Yeah.
Yay! Wait, Elmo's glad he has a nose.
Oh, a nose is great.
Yeah.
Unless you tell a lie like Pinocchio.
Pinocchio?
Yeah. Pinocchio's son was a little wooden boy.
Uh-huh.
Every time he told a lie, his nose got longer. What a catastrophe.
Oh, oh, look, look, look.
Huh?
Dorothy's imagining Elmo as Pinocchio.
Pinocchio lived with a kindly old woodcarver, Geppetto, who made him from a block of wood.
Oh, perfetto.
Pinocchio had one problem. When he told a lie, his nose grew longer. And he liked to make his nose grow.
Pinocchio ate the moon for breakfast.
Oh, a lie. The nose grows.
Pinocchio is 1,000 feet tall. Pinocchio's name is Cookie Monster. Pinocchio has 3 noses, 4 noses, 5 noses, 6 noses, 7 noses, 8 noses.
Pinocchio!
11 noses, 12 noses, 13 noses, 14 noses.
And that was true. So his nose got shorter.
Oh, my son!
Papa!
And nobody got hurt.
Now that was a good story. And that's the truth. Man, lots of noses today. Thank you so much for spending the day learning about noses with us.
Yeah, Elmo loves noses. And so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the nose song. Sing with Elmo.
Wherever you are. Hey, kid, looks like you got the seal of approval. Noses. That's without it.
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. That's Elmo's world.
Hi, welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo and his friends are happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy.
Ready for another fun day in Elmo's world?
Good. So are we. So, Elmo, what are you thinking about today?
Today, Elmo is thinking about up and down. You know, the things we do to make things go up and down, or the toys we play with to go up and down.
Oh, I know what you mean. Sometimes it's fun to go up and down. We can jump up and down, we can throw things high up into the air, until they fall back down. We can look up and down, go up and down the stairs. Even a yo-yo can go up and down when you play with it.
Oh yeah, that's true. Hey, what are some of the things you do that goes up and down?
Oh, that's good. I wonder what else can go up and down. There's lots of things that can go up and down.
I think I know what else goes up and down. But you'll need to play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
Now that's a good idea. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure out what else goes up and down.
We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game. Yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. You know what we need for Spot's Clues. Our handy dandy.
Notebook,
right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what else goes up and down. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we've got to find three.
Opens. Three paw prints, right. And we got to find our first clue.
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
And we got to find another paw print. That's the second clue. We put it in our notebook. Because these clues. Spot's Clues.
We got to find the last paw print. That's the third clue. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
You know what to do. Sit down in our thinking chair and think. Think. Think.
Take a step at a time. We can do
anything.
That we want to do. Are you ready? It's time to play Spot's Clues to figure out what else can go up and down. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you go up and down on a seesaw?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! Look! Shade is going up and down! Thank you, Shade! Oh, hi, Mr. Noodle! Hi! Elmo has an itch! Go down, 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 up, 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 up! Oh, yeah, there! Thank you, Mr. Noodle! Is Mr. Noodle ready for Dorothy's question? Good! How do you go up and down on a seesaw?
How you go up and down?
There's the seesaw.
There's the seesaw, Mr. Noodle.
How do you go up and down on it?
Sit on it.
Huh? Not in the middle, Mr. Noodle. You can't go up and down like that.
You have to sit.
on the end of the seesaw.
The end of the seesaw. Mr. Noodle?
Uh-oh, he went down.
But he can't go up.
You need someone to sit on the other end.
Yeah, on the other end. Yeah.
You can't seesaw alone.
Seesaws need two people.
You need two.
You need a partner.
Or a friend. Then you can go up and down.
What's he looking for?
What's that, Mr. Noodle?
What's he got?
It's an ant.
Mr. Noodle, you can't go on with an ant.
Uh-oh. Bye-bye, ant.
See? Mr. Noodle, you need something bigger to seesaw with you.
You need someone your size.
Yeah, try again.
Mr. Noodle, you need a bigger friend.
Think big. Think big. Think big.
Think big, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, Mr. Noodle has an idea. What are you doing, Mr. Noodle?
Mr. Noodle, that's too big.
He's big. Too big.
Mr. Noodle, you need someone your size.
He's too big.
He's gonna break the seesaw.
Well, how can you seesaw with Snuffy? Oh, okay.
What's he doing?
Oh, he's doing it. Up, down, up, uh-oh.
Mr. Noodle went way, way up.
Boy, I hope he'll be okay.
He'll be fine. He'll probably land somewhere soft by the time he comes down. But we can't wait for him to come down though, we've got some clues to find. Come on!
A clue, a clue!
Yeah, I'm sure Mr. Noodle will be fine.
No, a clue!
Oh, you see a clue. And it's on this cart. This cart is our first clue to what else goes up and down. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Me. I'll draw this clue. Let's draw two wheels on the bottom. A big shape like this for the cart. Color in the wheels, two lines on the side, two smaller ones on the side, and some lines right here in between. There, a cart. So, what else can go up and down with a cart?
Oh, good thinking. But let's find two more clues to figure this out.
In the meantime, Elmo has an up and down question.
Oh boy. What's your up and down question, Elmo?
Elmo wants to know, how many times can a hippo go up and down on a pogo stick? Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us.
Oh, there you are, hippo. Go ahead.
One, two, three, four, five.
You okay, Elmo?
Elmo's okay. Great counting, everybody.
And now... Elmo has mail! Computer fell down, go boom! Elmo will help it. Come on, computer,
Elmo has mail!
Oh, look. It's an email from Larry and Poppy. Hi guys, we wanna tell you about our favorite rides that goes up and down. My favorite ride that goes up and down is the drop tower. This is what it looks like. When you get on the ride, it starts to go up very slowly. And when it reaches to the top, it drops down very fast. But when it reaches near the bottom, It slows down and goes down slowly.
And I have two favorite rides that go up and down. My first one is the carousel, and my favorite is the Ferris wheel. On the carousel, there are some horses you ride on that goes up and down. And on the Ferris wheel, it goes around up and down. Those are my favorite kinds of rides.
Best rides we've been on. Bye guys. Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Must be pretty good rides for those two to be on.
Must be. I can see why those two like those rides. Good for them. Well, come on, let's go find Spot.
Hey, Elmo, I saw what happened to you. You okay? Elmo's fine. First time something like has happened. Good. Now, seeing how we're learning about up and down today, let's try to figure out something else that can go up and down. Open up drawer.
Can balloons take you up and down?
No!
Unless it's a hot air balloon. That can take you up and down. Can a chair take you up and down?
No!
What about a barber's chair?
Good idea! You can? Down! Can an elephant take you up and down?
No!
Unless it's me, I can take you up and down, cause I'm the elephant elevator operator! Going up!
A hot air balloon, a barber chair, and an elevator can definitely take you up and down. Good job figuring that out.
Until next time.
There's so many things that can go up and down. I wonder what Spot's thinking that can go up and down.
Hopefully we'll figure it out when we have all three clues. And we only have one. Come on, let's keep on looking for clues.
A clue, a clue.
You know something else that goes up and down?
No, a clue.
Oh, you see a clue. And it's on these tracks. These tracks are our second clue. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Elmo will. Elmo will draw two lines on top like this. And then some lines going down, like these. There, tracks. Okay, so our first clue is a cart. And now we have tracks.
So what else do you think can go up and down with a cart and tracks?
Yeah, maybe. But let's find our last clue to figure this out.
Bark, bark.
Oh yeah, we can watch the up and down channel. Turn yourself on TV.
Welcome to the Up and Down Channel, where things are always looking up and down. And now here's the Up and Down Lady.
I love stairs because I love going up and down. You can go upstairs and downstairs and up again and down again. Ha ha! That reminds me of a dance. Who's up for a dance? All right then, everybody up! And let's get down. Now there's a dance that's going around. The name of this dance is called the up and down. So take your hands and lift them high. Bring them down, then up as if you're learning to fly. Let me hear you say up, up. Let me hear you say down, down. It's the best dance in town. So come. Let me hear you say up, up. Let me hear you say down, down. It's the best dance in town. So come and do the up and down. It's the best dance in town. So come and do the up and down. Up, down, up, down. Yeah.
Thanks, TV. L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Hey, Spot Sky Dude into that game. Let's go. Spot Sky Dude. We can too.
Wow. What is this place?
Wiring.
Slides and ladders.
Slides and ladders?
Yes, slides and ladders. I'm the announcer. I'm in charge of announcing everything that happens here on this Gambert.
Oh, well, hello, Mr. Announcer. How do you play this game?
Well, Noya, it's quite simple. Each player puts their counter on the space that says start. They take turns to roll the dice. Move your counter forward the number of spaces shown on the dice. If your counter lands at the bottom of a ladder, you can move up to the top of the ladder. But if your counter lands on top of the slides, you must slide down to the bottom of the slides. The first player to get to the space that says finish is the winner.
Oh, okay. I think we kind of get it now. So, when we roll the dice, we move the number of spaces that's shown. If we get to the bottom of the ladder, we climb up, but if we get to the bottom of the slide, we slide down. Is that right?
Yes, sir, that is correct. Are you ready to play?
I think we are. Will you help us get to the finish? Great. Yes, sir, Mr. Announcer, we're ready to play.
Splendid. Now, roll the dice.
Wait, Elmo has a question. How does Elmo and his friends roll the dice?
Well, you push this button here.
Oh, so when we push the button, it'll roll the dice for us.
Exactly. The dots on each side of the dice will represent the number of spaces you move up to.
Oh, okay. Will you push the button? Great. Whenever you're ready.
How many dots are on the dice?
Five.
Five? Oh, yeah. One, two, three, four, five. That means we move five spaces east. All right, let's move five spaces. One, two, three, four, five.
Great work, players. You moved five spaces. Roll the dice again.
All right, roll the dice again. How many spaces are on the dice now?
Six.
Six. Three on the left, and three on the right.
Fantastic roll. Your next number is six. You must move six spaces. One to the right, one down, and four more west.
Right, got it. Here we go. One east, one down, and four more this way.
We made it to the number 11. And look, there's a ladder. What was it the announcer said when we get to the bottom of the ladder?
Climb up.
Right, we climb up the ladder. All right, everyone up. Nice work. We made it all the way up to the top of the ladder.
Great work. Now roll the dice again.
Will you do the honors?
And your next number is 3.
All right, 3 spaces here we come. 1, 2, 3. We're at the number 15. And look, we're at a slide. What happens when we get to a slide? Do we keep going east, or do we slide back down?
Slide down. Oh yeah. We slide down the slide. Let's slide.
Ha! That was fun. We made it all the way down to the bottom of the slide. We're at the number 20.
Elmo and friends must be getting close.
You've passed the slide. Well done. Now roll the dice and see where you land next.
What's our next number?
Six.
Six again? Wow, we're getting lucky. All right, six paces. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six.
Great job, you're almost to the finish. I think one or two more rolls should do it.
One or two more rolls. Let's hope we make it in one. What number is that?
Two.
The number two. We get to move two spaces like this. One, two. We did it. We finished the game.
Congratulations, Elmo and friends. You have finished the game. You're the champions.
All right, we're the champions. Thanks for helping us play this game. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have been able to get through all the slides and ladders.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Come on, we still have to find our last clue. By big booming announcer voice.
Thanks for playing.
All right, we're back. Now to go look for our last clue.
A clue! A clue!
You see our last clue? Where is it?
Oh, there it is. Our last clue is this line. An up and down line. All right, let's put it in our notebook.
I'll go first. Let's draw a line that goes up and down, like this. There, this line.
Okay, my turn. So we draw a line that goes up and down, like this. There, this line. Hey, that was our last clue. We have all three clues. That means we're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair, right. Come on.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think. So, what else can go up and down with a cart? Tracks.
And this line.
Well, what if this cart was on the tracks? Because carts and tracks go well together.
Yeah, that's true. But what about this line?
Well, what if these tracks were like this line that goes up and down? That's something the tracks could be. So, if there was a cart that were on some tracks that went up and down, what would that be?
A roller coaster.
A roller coaster. Yeah, that's it. Roller coasters have carts for you to ride in, tracks for them to move, and the tracks can go up and down. Roller coasters are fun to be on. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because they're really smart. Now that's smart thinking, Spot. Roller coasters are something that goes up and down. Smart thinking.
Thanks, I thought that was a good one too. Well, now that Elmo and friends figured out what else can go up and down, Elmo wants to learn more about up and down. How can Elmo find out more?
Oh! Hey, what's up?
I am.
Oh.
Now I'm down. Now I'm up again.
You're a yo-yo!
Well, thank you very much.
Wow. Well, what's it like being a yo-yo?
It has its ups and downs. Oh, you see this string here?
Yeah, Elmo sees the string.
Well, I can go up the string. And I can go down the string.
Cool.
Up and down.
Wow, yo-yos are very good at going up and down.
Well, thank you very much. But there are a lot of other things that are good at going up and down, too. Like a roller coaster.
Yeah, a roller coaster. Yeah. Oh, hey, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo on a roller coaster. Up.
Wow. What roller coaster of a ride.
Such a fun ride. Boy, what a fun up and down day. Thank you so much for joining us on this up and down day.
Yeah. Elmo loves up and down. And so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the up and down song.
Bye.
This is Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Elmo's ready for another fun day in Elmo's world with and his friends. Can you figure out what Elmo's thinking about today? Yeah, drums. Elmo's thinking about drums. Elmo loves drums.
Hey, what was that sound we heard?
Oh, Elmo was just telling our friends that Elmo's thinking about drums today.
Oh, drums. What a great thing to think about.
Yeah, drums are great instruments. Drums come in all shapes and sizes, and you can play with them either way. You can either use drumsticks to play with them, or just use your hands. How do you like to play with drums? Oh, that's good. Playing with drums is the best. Not only are they fun, but they also come in different names too.
That's true. Kind of make me wonder if anyone has a favorite drum to play with.
I'm sure they do. Even I have a favorite kind of drum. But you'll need to play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
That's a good idea. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game. Yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. You know what we need for Spot's Clues? Our handy dandy
notebook.
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of drums are. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we've got to find three
paw prints. Three paw prints, right. And we've got to find our first clue.
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
We've got to find another paw print. That's the second clue. We put it in our notebook. Because these clues. Spot's Clues.
We've got to find the last paw print. That's the third clue. We put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues.
You know what to do. Sit down in our thinking chair and think. Think.
A step at a time. We can do
anything.
That we want to do. Are you ready? It's time to play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of drums are. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you make music with a drum?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Oh, let's watch Mr. Noodle play with a drum! Mr. Noodle! Come on, Shag! We want to see Mr. Noodle! Thank you!
Hey, look. It's Mr. Noodle's brother, Mr. Noodle.
How do you play music with a drum, Mr. Noodle? Show us! No, you have to put it in the front, Mr. Noodle. The drum goes in the front, not in the back. You can't hit it that way. Go ahead, try again. You can get it. You did it before. Here you go. He did it! Yay! But now get the drumsticks, Mr. Noodle. So you can hit the drum. Get the drumsticks now.
Yeah, boom, boom, boom. It's the drumsticks that you make that boom, boom, boom.
If you turn around, it's the easier one to get the drumsticks.
Well, at least he figured out how to use the sticks to bang the drums. At least that's good. Well, now that Mr. Noodle answered Dorothy's question, it's time to go look for clues. Come on!
A clue! A clue!
You see our first clue? Where?
Oh, there it is. And it's on this drum. A drum is our first clue. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Noah and I will. I'll go first. First an oval on the top, a curved line here for the middle, the bottom, then some zigzaggy lines here. There, a drum.
Okay, my turn. So we draw an oval on the top, a curved line here for the middle, the bottom, and some zigzaggy lines right here. There, a drum. So, what could Spot's favorite drum be, with a drum? Probably. But let's find two more clues, just to be sure.
Ooh, but until then, Elmo has a question. For you guys, and you.
Ooh, is it about drums?
Yes. Elmo wants to know, how many drums are in this drum parade? Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us. Great counting, everybody.
Elmo has failed. Elmo has failed. Elmo has failed. Elmo has failed. Elmo has failed.
Computer! That's right. Everybody's got the beat today. Okay, computer, just fine. Elmo wants his email now. Thanks, computer.
Oh, look. It's an email from Larry. Hi, guys. I sent you this email to you that I know how to play the drums, and I'm still practicing. If you really want to play the drums, all you need to do is practice. Check this out. Just like that. Bye, guys. Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Now that was some good drum playing.
Very good drum playing. Way to go, Larry.
Oh, good. You're all here. It's time for a new drawer game.
Oh, boy. You're always full of ideas for a drawer game.
That's what I'm here for. And in this drawer game, we're gonna find other ways to play with drums.
Oh, boy. Let's have a look.
Do you play a drum with a stick?
Yes, but not that kind of stick. A drum stick. Not a chicken drum stick.
That's silly.
Yeah.
That's a bad kind of drum stick.
Yeah. Do you play a drum with a brush?
Yes, but not that kind of brush.
No.
That's a hairbrush.
No.
That's a toothbrush.
You don't play a drum with a toothbrush.
Yes, a drum brush.
Do you play a drum with a snuffle?
Maybe.
If you're a snuffle up against you do. Cool.
Those are all good ways to play with a drum. Don't you think? Thanks for that, Spot.
Anytime. Until next time. All this learning about drums makes Elmo want to play with drums now.
Well, we'll get together to play some drums later on. But until then, we still have more clues to find. Let's go.
A clue!
You see our second clue? Where?
Right there!
Oh, there it is. Our second clue is the color silver.
Ooh, silver. That's a good color.
Yeah, and we need to put it in our handy dandy
notebook.
Notebook, right. And we'll use this silver crayon for this silver clue. Let's draw a line that goes back and forth, like this. There, the color silver.
Okay, so what could Spot's favorite kind of drum be, with a drum?
And the color silver. Maybe. But I think we need to find our last clue, to figure this out.
Well, Elmo wants to learn even more about drums. How can we find out more?
Oh hey, TV. That's how we can find out more about drums.
Oh yeah. We can watch the Drums Channel.
Welcome to the Drum Channel. We're always on a roll. And now, here's the Drum Lady.
Hi there. I love to drum. I love to drum so much I sing about it. Come on, everybody, sing and drum along.
You can drum with your fingers, rat-a-tat-tat.
Rat-a-tat-tat.
You can drum with your thumb, thump, thump, thump.
Thump, thump, thump.
You can drum when you're happy, floppity-bop-yippee.
Floppity-bop-yippee.
You can drum when you're glum, boo-hoo,
boom-boom.
Boo-hoo,
boom-boom.
With your fingers, with your thumb, when you're happy, when you're glum, rum-tum-tum, everybody drum.
Drum!
You can drum with your daddy, poppity-pop-pop.
Poppity-pop-pop.
You can drum with your mum, tap-tip-toppy.
Tap-tip-toppy.
You can drum with your doggy, boom-boom-boom.
Boom-boom-boom.
You can drum with your chum, biddly-boop-bop.
Biddly-boop-bop.
With your daddy, with your mum, with your doggy, with your chum, rum-tum-tum, everybody drum. Drum, drum, everybody drum. Drum, drum, everybody drum. Rum, drum, 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 drum. Everybody drum.
Yeah.
Coming up next on the Drum Channel, Endless Drummer, followed by Drumbo.
Thanks, TV.
Come on. Let's go find Spot.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Hey, there goes Spot into that store.
Ooh, that must be a drum store. There's bound to be lots of good drums there. Let's go check it out.
All right. Spot's got to. We can too.
Wow. Look at all these drums.
Lots of different kinds of drums. Let's go look around.
Hello, welcome to my drum store. I need to go out and run some errands. Can you watch my shop while I'm gone?
Will you help us run the store? Great. Sure, we'll run the store.
Thanks, I'll be back.
Hello, I'm looking for an Indian drum to play with.
No problem, one Indian drum coming up. Spot, help me find one. Okay. So we need to find an Indian drum for our first customer. But what does an Indian drum look like?
Here's a picture of it to help us find one.
Oh, okay. So, we need to find the drum that matches this picture. Which drum is that?
That one.
Yeah, this is the Indian drum. This is the kind of drum you play in India.
All right, let's get this drum to the customer. Here you are, one Indian drum.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Enjoy your drum.
Nice work finding that drum, you guys. And good job helping them find the drum.
Hello, I'm a marching band person. And I'd like this drum for me to play in the band.
Ooh, no problem. Coming right up. Okay. We need a drum that matches the picture the band player showed us. Which drum is the one he showed us?
That one.
Oh yeah, this is the one the marching band player wants. Elmo likes this kind of drum.
Great, come on. One drum, for our marching playing friend.
Thank you very much. Now I'll be able to play in the band in no time. Thanks a lot.
So far, so good. You really do know your drums.
Hello, one set of bongos, please.
We'll get them. Come on, Blue. Okay, we need a set of bongos for our last customer. So let's see. Which one of these drums are bongos?
That one.
Bongos, here they are. You can tell these are bongos, because they're a set of two drums that are together. Pretty neat, isn't it?
Bark, bark.
Come on. Here you go, one set of bongos for you.
They're perfect. Wonderful. Thank you so much. I will. Thank you so much.
Oh boy, we did it. All the customers are satisfied with the drums we found for them. Thanks for helping us find the drums they were looking for. Boy, do you know your drums or what?
Hey, I heard the customers were satisfied with the drums they wanted. You all did such a wonderful job taking care of my store, and with the customers.
Well, we had some help with the customers.
I see. Well, thank you so much for your help. Come back soon.
We will. Hey, Spot, are any of these drums in this store your favorite?
Not quite. You still need one more clue to figure it out.
Then it looks like we're done here. All right, it's time to skydo back to Elmo's world and find our last clue. Let's go.
And we're back. Now let's go find our last clue.
You see the third clue? Where? Oh, on this sound. This sound is the third clue to what Spot's favorite drum is. Ooh, Elmo likes that sound. Ooh, but Elmo still needs to put the clue in his handy dandy
notebook!
Notebook, right. Since Elmo can't draw a sound, Elmo will draw some curves like these to help remember the sound. There, this sound. Hey, Elmo and his friends have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite drum is. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair. Come on. Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay, so we need to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of drum is. And our clues are, a drum.
The color silver.
And this sound.
So what kind of drum do you think is Spot's favorite, with a drum, silver, and this sound?
Well, what if this drum was silver? A nice silver drum. And maybe, this silver drum would make this sound. But what kind of drum is that?
A steel drum.
A steel drum. Yeah, a steel drum. I know that drum. It's a drum that's made from silver, and it makes a sound like this. We just figured out Spot's clues. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart. A steel drum. That's a good kind of drum to be your favorite, Spot.
Yeah, steel drums are the best. They sound really great too.
It's true, they sound really great when you play them. Well, now that we've figured out what Spot's favorite kind of drum is, I wonder what else we can find out more about drums.
Wonder who that is.
Hey! Wanna talk to some bongo drums?
Yeah. What's it like being drums, bongos?
Beats me. It's a good one, man.
Tell them about yourselves, bongos.
Okay, well, we're a musical instrument that you play with your hands.
Oh.
And we each have a different sound. Wow. Oh, try it.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Now try me, man.
Okay. See, different sounds.
Yeah,
and
different.
You can play us softly.
Okay. Right.
Or loud.
Loud? Okay.
You can play us slowly, too. Mm-hmm.
Slowly.
Yeah.
Or fast.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, man. Go, Daddy, go. Yes. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. You can play all kinds of different music on all kinds of different drums. Mm-hmm.
Really? Well, like what?
Well, you can play Caribbean music on the steel drum.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look, look, look! Daddy's imagining Elmos playing the steel drum.
Wow, now that's a good drum sound right there. Boy, this day has been filled with drum today.
Such a drumtastic day. Thank you so much for joining us on our drum day. It sure was fun to play with drums today.
Yeah, Elmo loves drums. And so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the drums song. Sing with Elmo.